Hello and welcome to a lecture on optical detectors part 2. Learning outcomes. By the end of this session, student will be able to derive the performance parameters of photodetecting materials. These parameters will be applicable to all the photodetecting materials. Here you may pause the video and try to find out the answer to this question. How is the energy of a photon related to its frequency? We know the formula for energy of a photon is E equals to hf, where h is Planck constant, f is frequency of a photon. So we can say that energy of a photon E is directly proportional to its frequency f, or in terms of wavelength, that is lambda, E equals to hc by lambda, where c is the speed of light, lambda is the wavelength of the photon. Quantum efficiency. The first parameter, quantum efficiency, is one of the most important parameters used to evaluate the quality of the photodetecting materials. Quantum efficiency quantifies the photon absorption ability of the photodetecting materials. Quantum efficiency is nothing but it is a measure of electrical power generated per unit incident optical power. Quantum efficiency is denoted by letter eta, and it is defined as it is the ratio of number of electron hole pairs generated that contributes to photocurrent to the number of incident photons. So we'll derive the equation for quantum efficiency. Suppose we have a photodetecting material with width w and absorption coefficient alpha at a specific wavelength lambda, and suppose we are incidenting optical power p0 on this photodetecting material, and we get the converted optical power as p0 times e raised to minus alpha w, where w is the width of photodetecting material. Here we are not considering the Fresnel reflection constant, which is nothing but the amount of photons reflected back at this interface. So the optical power absorbed in the depletion region would be 1 minus r times p0 times 1 minus e to the power minus alpha w, where P is incident optical power, R is Fresnel's reflection coefficient. So this whole term 1 minus R gives the amount of light incident on the material between on the interface at air and photodetecting material. So the number of photons absorbed by the materials becomes this optical power absorbed divided by the energy of a single photon, which is nothing but hf. So the total number of photon incident we can calculate by this formula, incident optical power p0 by hf. So if we divide this number of photons absorbed by the total number of incident photons, then we'll get the quantum efficiency. So this is so here the term in the numerator is nothing but the total number of photons absorbed, and this is nothing but in the denominator we have total number of photon incidents. So this hf term gets cancelled, p0 term get cancels, and we get quantum efficiency equals to 1 minus r times 1 minus e to the power minus alpha w, where r is Fresnel's reflection coefficient, alpha is absorption coefficient of photodetecting material, and w is a width of photodetecting material available for absorption of the photons. From this equation, it is clear that if we want to increase the quantum efficiency, we have to reduce the value of R, that is Fresnel's reflection coefficient, or by having higher absorption coefficient alpha, as well as by increasing the width available for absorption of the photon, we can increase the quantum efficiency. Here, point to note is that quantum efficiency is sometimes specified in terms of percentage. 75% of quantum efficiency means 75 out of 100 incident photons are absorbed for generation of photocurrent. Also, quantum efficiency and absorption coefficient alpha are specified at specific wavelength. So, the photon current is given by the formula 1 minus R times into P0 times 1 minus e raised to minus alpha w into electron charge e by hf. Unit of photocurrent will be amperes. We can increase the photocurrent by once again reducing the Fresnel's reflection coefficient or by increasing the absorption coefficient alpha or having wider width available for absorption of photons. The next parameter is responsivity. Responsivity gives the transfer characteristics of photodetecting materials, or in simple words, it gives the input-output gain of photodetecting materials. Responsivity is defined as, it is the ratio of photocurrent to the incident optical power. Previously, we have seen the expression of photocurrent and incident power is given by HF. Here we are calculating photocurrent generated to per unit incident optical power. So here we are taking just HF, which is nothing but a energy of a single photon. We know this 1 minus R times 1 minus e to the power minus alpha w is nothing but quantum efficiency eta. So we get responsivity as quantum efficiency eta times electron, that is e, by hf. Responsivity can be increased by increasing the quantum efficiency. Responsivity of a photodetecting material is directly proportional to the quantum efficiency of photodetecting material. Here, figure 2 shows the characteristics graph of responsivity versus wavelength. The unit of responsivity is ampere per watt, as it is a ratio of photocurrent to the incident optical power. The straight line is for ideal photodiode with quantum efficiency of 100%, and this curve is for silicon photodiode available commercially. Here the point to note is that the responsivity suddenly drops to zero after a specific wavelength. This wavelength is referred as long wavelength cutoff. The next performance parameter is long wavelength cutoff. We know the condition for absorption of photon is the incident photon energy should be greater than or equal to the band gap energy of the photodetecting materials. So therefore, we can write the equation as the energy of a photon, which is nothing but HF, should be greater than or equal to band gap energy of the material. If we rewrite this equation in rearrangement, we can write hc by lambda should be greater than or equal to eg. So once again we can rearrange the equation as lambda should be less than or equal to hc by eg, where h is Planck constant, c is speed of light, and e is energy band gap in electron volts. So this equation clearly indicates that there is a threshold for absorption of photon in terms of wavelength, which could be given as lambda c equals to hc by eg. This equation clearly states that if the photon with wavelength greater than this lambda c incident on a photo detecting materials, it won't get absorbed. These are the references. Thank you.